guys, so I randomly decided, and when I say randomly, I mean the last like 30 seconds, decided I want to take you guys to the grocery store with me because I think because I put on a cute outfit that I was like, ooh, like let's get jetty. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I'm going to the grocery store, I'm gonna run some errands, and I just was like, why don't I show you guys? Because I kid you not, I think like in 3 separate videos, I had filmed my grocery store excursion, and for whatever reason, they either failed like the time I got my card declined, or 2, the video is already too long and I just don't have space to put those clips in the video. So I just decided, I was like, I'm just gonna do my own separate video of going to the grocery store. And that's what this is. And it happened to me today. So it's a Sunday, so it's fitting. Some Sunday shenanigans. Also, I'm gonna stop into Main Street at Free People because there's these really cute pair of jeans that I've been wanting literally since December, and I still haven't purchased them. And they finally came out with like a little different pair that's tweaked a little bit, and I love them even more. They have buttons on the front, they're really wide bootlegged. They have like a different texture on the bottom. I'm obsessed with them, and so I need to go buy them. So we're gonna go do that too. But first, outfit check, hang on. Okay, before you say anything, I already know what I'm missing. I really need like little like cute ruffly socks, but we'll get there. So I'm out of breath. Also, hi you guys. I missed vlogging. I feel like it's been so long. This jean jacket isn't like, I don't think it's the cutest thing in the world with it, but it's a little bit chilly and I need a little bit of something something. This is super overexposed. There we go. But this is like wicked old. My mom's in the 80s or the 90s. The inside's really funk sauce. But then this dress I actually got in a boutique when I was in Virginia. It's Billabong though, so I bet you can find it somewhere. It's just like this really cute like yellow with white flower dress. I just think the print is so cute. Then these are my Nike Air Max 98s. Okay, that just took way longer than expected. What else is new? But basically, I was gonna like, I was dead set on getting the normal denim pair. That's the image I had in my mind. But then for sizing, I tried on the black pair to try on that size because I didn't have that size in the normal jean. And then I tried on the black ones and I fell in love with those too. And I was like, which wash do I get? It's not in my budget to get both. And so after consensus, I decided to get the black. I don't know, but I can return them or exchange them. So that's, we're going with that. Also, their bag is like so cute. Hi, I shop at Walmart, so I usually always forget my reusable bags, but not today, boys. I got a good amount of like my staples, so it was like definitely a pretty solid thorough grocery haul, and I'm excited to show you guys. I literally, my heart was beating when I went to my card, and I was like, if I get declined right now, I'm gonna be pissed, because also because I just spent money on those clothes. But I was like, wait, actually let me see if I can do a transition. 3, 2, 1. Did it work? I hope it did. Okay, so I tried to organize. Wait, $1 million question that I just thought of. Is an avocado a fruit because there's a pit? Or is an avocado a vegetable? Is it C, none of the above? I don't know. You tell me, let me know, because I'm actually really curious. Okay, also keep in mind, I live with my brother, so him and I both eat this, and I just looked at the receipt, it was $66.80, which isn't that bad for a lot of really good, nutrient-dense purchases. Let's start with fruit, because I just really like fruit. First off, bananas, really love bananas, they're also super cheap. We have apples, Gala apples are the best. No ifs, ands, or buts. I used to like Honeycrisp. They're a little bit too bitter for me now. Like, they're almost too sweet for me now. Cilantro, because I'm gonna make tacos tonight, so can't go wrong with the cilantro. I've honestly been putting it on anything, everything. It's good in salads. It's good on top of a turkey burger, which I make those a lot, so love that. Next is strawberries. This is definitely another staple. My top 3 fruits that I have all the time, apples, bananas, strawberries. Definitely for all of my oatmeal and stuff. Also, I love putting them on rice cakes. Then in terms of veggies, sweet potatoes. Love sweet potatoes. It's such a good form of starchy carbohydrates. Then I am obsessed with broccoli too for some reason. I love frozen broccoli. It's super easy to whip up. So I got some of that. Baby spinach. I love putting this in my eggs with some of the turkey sausage that I have, so I use that a lot. I have a red onion because I cook with it a lot, obviously, for salads on top of turkey burgers, like I said. I also make this really good mixture of it's like a kind of a quinoa salad with salmon on top, and you need red onion. So good. I have an actual avocado, but it's not, none of the avocados there were close to being ripe, which is always such a sad moment. So then I also got some plain Jane guac, which I don't know how this is gonna be, but I was desperate and I really wanted guac tonight with my tacos. So I got this. And then some fresh basil, which that reminds me, I really want to go buy a basil plant. Like, mark my words, I'm gonna do it, because it's just like annoying and kind of expensive to buy like four leaves of basil when you can just have your own plant. Again, love this to cook with, amazing in salads, also really good with that salmon salad that I was talking about. That's originally why I got it. Cherry grape tomatoes, or whatever you want to call it, love these as well. The best taco seasoning on the planet is the McCormick. Don't come at me, it's proven. Let's go into some canned goods, some plain canned corn. Pro tip, make sure you get whole kernel. I still remember to this day, like one of the first times like that I had went and bought corn by myself, really random story, but I accidentally got cream style, tragedy. I didn't even know it was a thing. So make sure you get whole kernel or else it's gonna be smush. Where are my tuna lovers at? I don't know if it's just me, but I love getting tuna. Super easy for me to have for lunch for like a really quick protein source. And I really like to diversify how much meat I'm eating. So I like to have this as like a fish option that's really quick and easy. And I always get mine in water. Also, if you don't like your tuna super smushy, that's another thing. A lot of people don't like tuna because it's like smushy when they open up the can. Get Alcobor solid white tuna. It's a little more like firm and has more of a shape, so you might like it better. And you guys, tell me this is a snack that you forgot about, don't even lie. Normal sliced peaches. Now, I used to have these a lot when I was in elementary school. My mom used to pack them for me in my lunch. I love peaches. And these are so nice because they never go bad. They're super quick to easy to open it like the can and just have them straight out of the can. I ate these straight out of the can today. And I just love them and they're so sweet. So this is a really good one because you really wanna make sure when you're buying like canned fruit that there's not a ton of extra sugar or extra preservatives or anything like that. So this one is the best one that I could find. There is some sucralose in here, but it was honestly the cleanest one that I could find. And this is the almond butter that I get. It's honey almond butter. It's so freaking good. I love this stuff. And this one is super, super natural. All it is almonds, honey powder, palm oil, and sea salt. Now let's go into some meat sources. This stuff is my MO, you guys. If you like breakfast meat, like, and you're a fiend for bacon, you have to get this. It is the best bacon I've ever had. And I sometimes, like with bacon, I feel like, I don't wanna use the word guilty, but just like a lot of bacon has extra preservatives and stuff in it. I'm talking even turkey bacon. There's a lot of extra chemicals and preservatives in there. So I'm like, I know this isn't the best thing for me to be eating every morning, but I really love turkey bacon. And this one is the most natural I can find. And it's amazing, cheap, right at Walmart. So this one specifically has no nitrates or nitrates added, and it's not preserved. And it's uncured turkey bacon. And that's what you really want to look for when buying turkey bacon, is to make sure it's uncured, because that's how you know there'll be not a lot of extra ingredients. So right here in the ingredients list, it literally says all that it is turkey meat, water, sugar, salt, vinegar, and celery powder. So I swear by this, I absolutely love it, and it tastes so freaking good. 5 grams of protein for no carbs and 2.5 fat per slice. Like, thank you, go get this. Then some plain old chicken breast. It's not organic, it's not free range, but we were balling on a budget, so chicken sometimes grosses me out, but you gotta do what you gotta do, man. I got a big thing of ground turkey, which I like to split this up, so I use this for turkey burgers, for my tacos and stuff like that. I make a lot of different stuff with this. I personally always get the 93.7. I've gone through phases where I'm like, get the 99.1, sister, and it's rubber. So I find the 93.7 is a good happy medium. It's not super, super lean, but it's also not super fatty. And then I already had, I don't want you guys thinking that I don't buy any like processed stuff, because I do, trust me. I just still have some popcorners left, and I have 2 different things of rice cakes left, and that's kind of pretty much the only things that I like snack on. But I did add to the collection, and I got blue corn tortilla chips. I love these. These are phenomenal for some reason. I don't know why they're so good. Like, they're just trusty, they're so good. They're organic and they're just tortilla rounds, and they're blue corn. And literally the only ingredients are organic blue corn, organic sunflower oil, organic safflower oil, and sea salt. That's it, but they're so good. And lastly, but not least, these are the treats that I love to have at the end of the day. They're the dark chocolate Oreo Thins, best flavor out there, 100%. Love these. Always dip them in oat milk at night. Phenomenal. Love them. The mint flavor is not that bad, but like first I tried the mint flavor, love them. They're like, these taste like Thin Mints. Then I went to the dark chocolate ones, could never go back. Could never go back. The cream is a lot creamier. It just, you have to get the dark chocolate ones. I'm also a chocolate fiend, so maybe that's why I like them. All right, that's everything I got. I'm so stoked that I was finally able to take you guys through a mini grocery store haul, because honestly, that's like what my trips look like. A majority of the time, a variation of that. Sometimes I'll get different vegetables and things like that, but those are the main things. I also usually will have salmon in there. That's another big protein source for me. But again, I usually get that at a different store because I just really can't do the Walmart salmon anymore, you guys. I can really strongly taste the difference with it now, and I just can't do it anymore. So that's everything. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you haven't already, don't forget to like this video. It really helps out my channel, and subscribe if you're down. I'd love to have you along. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm sending you so much love, and hopefully I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace out.